The Nintendo DS is an interesting handheld console. It's the most successful handheld console produced, and the second best-selling console overall if you count home consoles too. For a lot of people, the DS was the first touchscreen device they used. Despite not being a powerful system, it seemed somewhat futuristic because of the touch controls, even though it actually had relatively low-tech components otherwise. The DS had great timing as well, since it came out before the dawn of the smartphone era. The Nintendo DS had a very long lifespan and technically continues to live on as the 3DS, or more specifically the new 2DS XL, which hasn't been discontinued yet. And that still has DS backwards compatibility. There's an interesting variety of hardware that's been released over the years, and there's plenty of games too. And best of all, the system is relatively cheap to get into compared to some of the others. This is largely due to the fact that DSs and devices that can play DS games are plentiful. Of course, there are exceptions. Pokemon games can get quite expensive, but that always happens with older systems. The PS2 is a bit similar in that regard, probably because they're from the same era and have almost identical sales figures. But this isn't a video about the PS2, I already made one about a few months ago. No, let's keep focusing on the DS. Whether you want to get started collecting, just want to get a couple of games, or just want to know about the system generally, this video will be a good place to get an overview of the Nintendo DS. We'll talk about a variety of topics, but first we should start looking at the hardware. Essentially, there are 10 different consoles that can play physical DS games. The original DS, a more streamlined version, which is also the most common one, the DS Lite, and the DSi and DSi XL, which feature bigger screens and extra features. Then there's the 3DS family of systems, which consists of the 3DS and 3DS XL, the 2DS, the new 3DS and new 3DS XL, and finally the new 2DS XL. So that's a couple of decades worth of hardware right there, making the DS quite an accessible console. Depending on what you want to do, you might prefer one or more models over some of the others. For pure DS gaming, I would recommend either a DS Lite or one of the DSIs, whether it's the regular one or the XL. The DS Lite is the most common model and therefore the most affordable. The Lite's battery is also amazing. You can leave them sitting around for a year and they still have enough charge for several hours of playtime. At least that's been my experience. These systems, along with the original FAT model, are also Game Boy Advance backwards compatible. There are a few things you might want to take into consideration though. Apparently the hinges can be quite fragile. I bought one that was very much abused and it broke a few weeks into ownership, but I've got two other examples that are fine. It seems like a common problem since a lot of people bring it up. Another thing to look out for is the screen, or screens rather. There seems to be different types. I have three lights, all with different screens. The beat up white one has a decent amount of ghosting, which means the image looks blurry during motion. The blue DS light has a warmer yellowish tint with much less ghosting. And my silver handheld has a more bluish look, or color balance, with about the same amount of ghosting. So not much of it. If you really don't want the ghosting, you may have to search for one of the later models. If it doesn't bother you, then you could also go for an older FAT DS. Some people like the way it feels to hold since it's a bit girthier. Like I said, I recommend a DSi and DSi XL as well. Even the regular DSi has a bigger screen than the original and Lite models. There's no obvious ghosting, and the battery is still really, really good, despite not lasting as long as the Lite. There's no hinge problems either, but you do lose GBA backwards compatibility. Now let's talk about the 3DS and its derivatives. It is a good choice because even discontinued models are relatively new, it's not really expensive, and not to mention you get to play 3DS games with it as well. For versatility it's great, but for a pure DS experience I still recommend an actual DS. Here's why. DS games are scaled to fit the 3DSs, which makes the image blurry. You can hold start or select when starting up a DS game in order to have a pixel perfect image, but unless you have an XL model of some sort, you'll get a tiny picture. I think non-scaled DS games look fine on an XL model 3DS, but it's a bit weird to have that wasted screen space. But hey, for some people a 3DS might be the way to go because of the versatility. I should mention that there are DS games that make use of special accessories that go into the GBA slot of the original FAT DS as well as the Lite. So anything newer than those, like the DSIs and the entire 3DS family, isn't going to work with those accessories. Because of the DS's popularity, there are a lot of games available. Let's cover Nintendo stuff first. There's a good selection of Mario games, as one might expect. Super Mario 64 DS is a remake of Super Mario 64. I like that it has two console names in the title. It's a remake of Super Mario 64 with several additions, including the ability to play as different characters. Mario Kart DS is fun as well. A lot of people like it because of the track selection, and it also makes good use of the DS's bottom screen, as it offsets things like the map onto it, which frees up the main screen. I also enjoyed New Super Mario Bros. If it's a side-scrolling Mario game, I'm going to like it, so that's that. Something I don't have experience with is Mario & Luigi, Bowser's Inside Story, but I am mentioning it because it's something I see a lot of people talk about here and there. The Mario & Luigi games are RPG-based, which I think is quite interesting, so you might want to take a look at that. Zelda Phantom Hourglass is a game I found quite enjoyable. It's a sequel to Wind Waker, which makes it interesting to me. It makes use of the stylus quite a bit, which was a bit too much at times. I often wanted a regular D-pad instead, but I still thought the game was fun overall. A cool thing is that boss fights make use of both screens, so you feel like you're battling gigantic colossal monsters. There's also several Pokemon games. After a brief absence from the series during the Gen 3 era, I got right back into it with the Gen 4 and 5 games on the DS. I had a lot of fun with Pokemon Platinum. The introduction of online trading was amazing, and there's something about the Sinnoh region that was really compelling. Heart Gold and Soul Silver were really awesome remakes of their second gen counterparts. Having access to both the Johto and Kanto regions is excellent. I also recommend checking out the Gen 5 games. I initially dismissed Pokemon Black and White and Black and White 2 when they first came out, but when I actually gave the games a go, I really enjoyed the storyline. It's a bit moody and melancholic, which is a nice shift in tone for the series. It's also amazing how nostalgic you can feel over certain locations when playing through Black and Black and White 2. For me, the DS was a real Pokemon machine. That's primarily what I played on it, so I don't have much experience with other franchises on the system. But I do know that several JRPGs ended up on the system too. Some were new, while others were ports of older, highly revered games. Chrono Trigger, Radiant Historia, Disgaea, Shin Megami Tensei, Dragon Quest. The list goes on with a lot of known franchises and more obscure offerings too. And as always, I need to continue mentioning Okami whenever I can, so let's do that now. Okami has a sequel that is a DS exclusive called Okamiden. Definitely something to give a go if you can. Another good way to see what's out there is to look at all the various best games lists on the internet. The funny thing is that a lot of these lists don't share that many games in common, which shows you how many different types of games there are and how different people's tastes can be. An often overlooked way to play DS games is to get them through the eShop on the Wii U. Of course, the selection is limited, but it's worth looking at if you have a Wii U. I also have an R4 card, which accepts microSD cards and allows you to put a bunch of ROMs on there. There's several types of R4 cards, and the one I have is a bit older. Just googling R4 cards gives you several guides on the, you know, all the different ones. Some work on 3DSs as well, while others don't. Something I'm sure people will bring up are emulators. I use Desmume, or however you pronounce that, for some of the footage I recorded. That seems to be the most popular and best working DS emulator on PC. Emulation isn't really going to give you the real experience of using a stylus on the screen, but it's an option, especially if you want to do like upscaling and other graphic improvements. I still prefer to experience the console hardware, especially as they get older. One of my favorite things about having the hardware is interacting with it, the games, accessories, and all that stuff, especially because of the dual screens and the touchscreen. There are some accessories you might want to consider. Let's talk about the stylus first. For a lot of people, the ones that come with the system are fine. For me, they're so thin that they're causing a bit of trouble with my hand, as in it cramps up. So you may want to take a look at getting something a little bit more ergonomically shaped. The problem is that a thicker stylus makes it hard to see the screen sometimes, but I've found these official DS ones to be a decent compromise. I also like to have a variety of cases on hand. A lot of them are quite clever with how they store various items. Some are quite simple and just hold the system, while others do a bit more and have compartments for not just games, but also styluses and various other accessories. I like the more elaborate cases because they allow me to keep everything I need at hand. The nice thing is that the 3DS cases will work with DSs and vice versa. Of course, DS XL and 3DS XL systems will need something sized appropriately. And with the 2DS, well, I guess that's its own thing when it comes to cases. That one has the most unique form factor. I will say that none of the stores where I live really carry much 3DS stuff anymore. It's usually just the 2DS XL itself, a few games, and that's it. So finding cases is probably more like an internet endeavor. Or if you have any secondhand video gaming stores, then, you know, check those out. So, that's the Nintendo DS. I hope you found this overview of it helpful or entertaining. I've done several of these types of videos for not just consoles, but also game franchises. So take a look at the top right for a card with a link to the playlist. On the Patreon side of things, I added some new promo codes for the merch store. So hopefully some of you can make use of that. Take a look if you're interested. There should be a card as well. If not, check out the description because it contains all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.